Hello everybody, good morning and welcome to the United Stand. Hope you're doing well. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer with a big Pogba warning. I'm telling you now, he has got to get Pogba into the team, and it's nothing to do with what anybody's personal opinion is about Pogba. He's got to get players like Pogba and Van der Beek into that team if he wants to keep his job at Manchester United. It's as simple as that. It's as simple as that. We'll be talking about that why as well. But look, I get it. There's a lot of people very angry, a lot of people very frustrated. How do I feel this morning? I just am absolutely stunned by some of the messages I was getting last night about Bruno being shit. Created the most chances in the Nations League across Europe. He's created the most chances in the Premier League. More than De Bruyne, more than Grealish, more than anybody. And he's played a game less than most of them. People want to criticise Bruno Fernandes. I don't care if rivals want to do it. Collect your tears in pint glasses. But Manchester United fans criticising Bruno Fernandes. I've supported this club for well over 35 years. I've seen comings and goings. He's the closest thing we've got to a Roy Keane that we've ever had in 10 years. And he's nothing like Roy Keane as a player. But his attitude, his demand to win, the fact that the penalty, he's in the box. His heat map is everywhere. His ability on the ball is unparalleled. He does give the ball away, but he takes risks most people won't. Scott McTominay, Fred, Matic, they give the ball away doing 5-yard sideways passes. Fred, Bruno's looking to hit 30-yard passes and break a defensive line. Fantastic performance. Where would we be without him? And also, how many goals and assists would Bruno have if some of our strikers could actually assist? If he's creating more chances than anybody in the Premier League and across Europe, what a player we've got there. But we need more. And what I would say this morning, we needed that win last night. Whether you want Solskjaer to be sacked or not, we needed that win last night. But look, let me just go to this. Thanks to the Flick app, link in the video description, download it. There's a very interesting poll on there about Solskjaer's future. Will he be Manchester United manager come Christmas? Link in the video description, download that. We'll talk about that in a minute, but I just want to go straight to the tactics board here. Right, this is how we lined up yesterday. So, what am I talking about? This ball here, this is what Manchester United were like in the first half, a lot. And you can check your heat maps out, you can do what you like. We had a back four, we had Fred and Matic close to that back four. You've got Bruno here, Mata, Rashford, Martial. The gap from that defensive six to that front four is shocking. It's absolutely shocking to be like that at home against West Brom. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer said, it's never comfortable against players of this quality. What quality? They're relegation fodder. It's never comfortable against players of this quality. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer came off the bench against Nottingham Forest and scored 4 goals, and we beat them by 8 goals at the City Ground. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer has been part of United teams that used to blast this sort of team. What is he talking about? It's never comfortable against players of this quality. It's West Brom. I think if they kept playing till now, they wouldn't have scored. They were a hard-working, energetic, well-organised side, but they haven't got the quality to stay in the Premier League. So what's Ole Gunnar Solskjaer coming out saying it's never comfortable against players of that quality? The whole point about West Brom is they don't have any quality. That's why they're going to go down. Any West Brom fan will tell you that. You've got to be more expressive. And when I look at Manchester United, and somebody said to me today, this morning, I put it on Twitter actually, Maguire and Lindelof are not getting the praise they deserve. They've been solid recently. I tell you what, me and Ricky would be a solid centre-back pairing if we had these two in front of us, him behind us, and these full-backs tucking in. They've got more protection than Tin Man's arse. They are so protected, and now people are trying to tell you that Maguire and Lindelof are a good partnership. They're sucking the life out of this team because of Ollie's tactics. He's so scared of Maguire and Lindelof's inability to deal with a quick ball that he's surrounding them with protection. They're basically in bubble wrap. They're like an ornament in bubble wrap. They've got De Gea playing the best he's played in years behind him. They've got Wan-Bissaka tucking in so much he's not covering his back post. And he's got McTominay and Fred, or Matic and Fred, in front of them. They are protected. They may as well be a bloody president of the USA with his bloody hit squad around him. They are so protected. And we are playing so defensive. And this is why he's in big trouble, Solskjaer, if he doesn't start being brave. He's trying to... Look, Martial was isolated. He was totally isolated. He didn't play well. Martial didn't play well. I'm not protecting him. But for a home game, this is what it was like. This was our setup in the first half. That's a Manchester United striker at home against West Brom. And look how we're set up. That's defensive. We're set up as a defensive side away from home. And this is why, for me, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer has got to get better players into the team. He's got to go on the front foot because that formation is not going to work against Southampton, Man City, PSG, Leipzig and West Ham. They will beat us because they have got more quality than West Brom. And he's got to use better players. What I would do, and I think most people would agree with me with this, what I would do is I would take out Matic. I would bring in, where's Freddie? Fred would go across to here for me. Obviously, Bruno is Bruno's going to stay in his position as per usual. We're not going to move Bruno. But he's got to make changes that are going to make us play better as a side. And look, I'm not a massive fan of Paul Pogba. I don't think anybody is at the moment. But Paul Pogba plays with Kante for France. Get your midfield right. Push your fullbacks on more. And more importantly as well, get rid of Mata and get in Donny van der Beek. Because, you know, the team changes instantly. If you do that, instantly. What's Donny van der Beek's number? I can't remember what his bloody number is. Number 34. Why is he not highlighting me? Oh, fucking hell. There he is. Just get rid of Mata. And that team is better straight away. And it's progressive. It's got more energy in it. And he's got to do that. He's got to do that. He's got to get Pogba and Van der Beek into the team. Because at the moment, he's playing like a coward. He is cowardly putting two CDM. He's playing not to lose. He's playing not to lose against West Brom at home. What's he going to do against Southampton? What's he going to do against PSG? What's he going to do against Leipzig, West Ham, Man City? You've seen the blueprint there yesterday against West Brom. And it's that negative football I was showing you before. It's defensive counter-attacking football. That's what we're doing. He's better than that. We haven't always played like that under Ollie. He's got to go to a more offensive way of playing. You cannot... Look, I don't think Pogba has much of a future at Manchester United. I totally agree with that. But he's here till the summer. You can't... I mean, Matic was poor yesterday. McTominay's not much better. We are picking two players and sacrificing a quality player to play two CDMs. That's what I'm trying to get across this morning. That's what I'm frustrated about. The reason you're moaning about Van der Beek playing, the reason some people are not happy that Pogba doesn't play, and look, Pogba was injured yesterday, but Van der Beek wasn't. The reason you've got Van der Beek and Pogba... I mean, look, our three best midfielders, creativity-wise and talent-wise, are Bruno Fernandes, Donny van der Beek and Paul Pogba. And is anyone going to argue with me about that on talent? Not necessarily on consistency, but on talent, our best three midfielders, and probably our best three players in the squad, really, are Bruno, Pogba, Van der Beek, right? Two of them are always on the bench now. Why are two of our better players always on the bench? Because we're playing two CDMs. Do you think Matic looks any good? Matic needs a bloody shower in WD-40, he's so bloody rusty. Mata's starting games. Mata needs a new battery. You know, he's running on empty. We've got to get our better players into the team. But what we need to accept here is that Solskjaer is playing not to lose. He's playing like a coward because he's under pressure. Pochettino's waiting and Solskjaer's doing what he always does. People were saying to this me over the international break. And I'm not Ollie out. We won yesterday, but he's going to lose his job. I'll tell you this now. If he keeps going with yesterday, he's going to lose his job. But a lot of people said to me over the international break, it's frustrating. It's really frustrating because when every time Ollie's about to get the sack, they pull a result out. They all, you know, the Duracell bunnies are there. I don't think it's even that. I think what happens is when you think about a year ago, we had to play Mourinho, Spurs and Man City. And he was on the verge of the sack. And everyone said, Poch will be in by Christmas a year ago. So careful what you wish for. It won't happen. But he went and beat Spurs and Man City. He went and beat Everton before the international break. He's done it a few times. But I'll tell you this. Go back and look at those teams and tell me he didn't go defensive counter-attacking football in every one of those games. He knows, unfortunately, and somebody said last night, and it was a great comment, that win last night could set us back weeks because his last two wins have been snorefest. Most United fans, whether they're Ollie in or Ollie out, were appalled. My phone last night, social media, people were even sympathetic to West Brom because the way we played was crap. I mean, statistically, we had about 15 shots and 7 on target. I mean, I don't remember most of those, but the reality is, the way we are playing against everybody now is counter-attacking defensive football. And he's going to keep doing it because he's trying to keep his job. And we're going to get bored. And we're going to see Van der Beek and Pogba on the bench. for a lot of the next few weeks. Those two, if you're Pep Guardiola or you're Jurgen Klopp or you're Zinedine Zidane or you're Pochettino or any decent coach, there is no way in the world you sit there on a Friday night before a game on a Saturday and go, I've got Pogba, Van der Beek and Bruno, I'm going to bench two. You're thinking, how do I get all three in the team? Because they can definitely all play together as well. They definitely can play all together. And I'll tell you for why. It's there. What can't speak can't lie. You've got Fred, Bruno, Pogba, Van der Beek still in the same team, playing a system that can work. But he's terrified, absolutely terrified of Maguire and Lindelof's lack of pace. And he's also terrified of the fact that Matic can't do the job on his own. McTominay can't do the job on his own. You know what? Manchester United should get in a big circle and do ring a ring of roses, because that is effectively what we're doing at the moment. We're playing this protect each other football, and it's causing us massive problems. Matic can't do the role of a CDM on his own anymore, so put Fred next to him. McTominay can't do it on his own, so put Fred next to him. Lindelof and Maguire lack pace, so tell Wan-Bissaka to tuck in and put two CDMs in front of them. Everybody is being protected. We're Manchester United. Now, I can't sit here tonight and this morning and say, we're Manchester United, we should be blasting West Brom 5-0. Realistically, we haven't really been doing that for a decade. We're Manchester United, we should be fighting for titles. We should, but realistically, we've not been doing that for 7-8 years. I accept that there has been a massive, massive drop-off there. But the reason there's been a drop-off is because some things have been allowed to drop off. Look, the board don't do a great job, we know that. But you shouldn't have players in a Manchester United shirt that have to be protected. Like, you know, I've coached, I've played, we've all done it, whether it's five-a-side or whatever. Sometimes there's a player on your team that's shit. You try and put them in goal, but then you're like, we've got to stop them having shots. We've got players in our team that we are protecting. We are protecting them. We are benching quality players to play Duracell bunnies to protect inadequate players in Manchester United shirts. I would rather Twansebi play raw because he's got the raw attributes and he makes a few mistakes, but we play more expansive football. Twansebi is the quickest centre-back we've got available. He should be playing so we can play a higher line. Yes, he's going to make mistakes like he did against Denver Bar, but Harry Maguire could have got sent off yesterday. Just before the penalty, he pulled at him and he nearly tripped him up. It was outside the box. He was one-on-one. It would have been a red card. It was at the start of second half. We would have been screwed. We are going to... Better teams are going to exploit our slow centre-backs more and more and more. And Ollie knows that, so he's going to play deeper and deeper and deeper, and he's going to play more CDMs. Scholesy said it last night. We're playing two CDMs because it provides protection for the defence. And it's not the Manchester United way. We need to be more expansive. I always remember Rio and Vidic, basically. They would send the fullbacks forward, the midfielders forward. I think sometimes they even sent bloody... What's his name? Van der Sar forward. They didn't care. As a centre-back pairing, as a two, they were confident they could deal with anything. Lindelof and Maguire can't do that. We are over-protecting players. And we've got one CDM, like I say, but we play two because we haven't got anybody good enough. I worry about Manchester United's future, the immediate future and the long-term future. Because even if we don't have a CDM and we don't have a centre-back partnership, they are two of the most important areas in football. And at the moment, we've got strikers who aren't scoring goals, which is another important area. But I want to address the main issue about Manchester United at the moment. Tactically, it's all right, strikers. Strikers missing chances becomes more important when they're not getting many. You know, Rashford missed a big chance. Martial missed a big chance. That was pretty much their chances for the game, wasn't it? In a better side, they'll get more chances. And, you know, Aguero misses a chance. You forgot about it in 3 minutes because you'll get another one and score it. At United, you miss your chance. That's it. You're not getting another one. That's what you've got for dinner and you can either eat it or you get nothing. That's how United work. But defensively, the spine of the team is your centre-backs and your CDM, massively part of it. We don't have players to do that role. Manchester United are now sending I don't like the word coward, but we are sending a team out that's cowardly because we're over-protecting players. Pogba's absence didn't have an effect yesterday. Time for him to go. We would have won the match easily if we were more clinical in front. We need a more clinical finisher and get rid of Pogba, says Pranay. Mate, I think you need to go and watch the game again. What match did you watch yesterday? We would have won the game comfortably if we took our chances. We had two chances. They had two chances. One hit the bar and De Gea made a world-class save. Don't try and repaint a very good win as we didn't need Pogba, mate. If you don't, you've got to watch football and understand what we did yesterday. We played two centre defensive midfielders, we played a deep defensive line, and we tried to counter-attack a very energetic West Brom side at home. And we won 1-0. It's not good enough. It's not good enough. And I actually love the fact that there are United fans last night and this morning not happy, even though we won, because the bigger picture is we're on the verge of a bad result. We're going to get beat by a good team very, very soon if we keep playing this style of football. Our midfielders haven't got a passing range other than Bruno. Our centre-backs haven't got any pace. Our full-backs can't get forward because they're terrified of our centre-backs getting exploited. We are a defensive side at the moment. He's got to change it. And don't tell me that Pogba wouldn't have made a difference yesterday if he'd have been fit, because Fred and Matic weren't very good. And Paul Pogba plays for France with Kante or Matuidi or whoever in a midfield two pivot. So Paul Pogba is better than those players. I don't care whether Paul Pogba's going to go to Real Madrid or Juventus. I don't care if Paul Pogba has disrespected Ollie or anything like that. We have got 6 months till Paul Pogba leaves this club. You're going to sit him in the reserves and watch that shit like yesterday every week, or are you going to get your better players on the pitch? Now, if he comes into the pitch and he doesn't do well, fine. But I think he wasn't fit before the international break. I think he needs to put himself in the shop window, and we need to get our better players on the pitch. And to be honest with you, I'm sick and tired of agendas. I'm really tired of it. It's boring. Like, if you think a player's not good enough, that's fine. But Paul Pogba needs to start for Manchester United next to Fred. Bruno needs to be in front of them. Donny van der Beek needs to be on the right. Rashford on the left. Martial up front. And that's how the team should be. And there's no logical reason why we shouldn't do that. Against Sevilla, Fred, Pogba and Bruno was the best midfield performance I've seen in a year at United. Why have we not done it again? If you're playing Mata on the right wing, you could play me on the right wing. So play van der Beek, who's way better than both of us. Rashford, look, not very good yesterday, but Martial not very good yesterday, but sort that bloody midfield out. You cannot have Mata and Matic and Fred and Bruno as a midfield four when you could put van der Beek and Pogba in the team. Put your better players on the pitch and start getting some bloody results, because if we keep going the way we did yesterday, we're in for a very, very bumpy ride to Christmas, because that team yesterday needs to pimp its ride up, otherwise it's going to get beat and beat badly very, very soon. Van der Beek needs to start against Istanbul. If he doesn't start against Istanbul, there's a big issue, because he won't start against Southampton or PSG the following games. He needs to start Van der Beek. He needs to play Van der Beek with Bruno, because we need to win that game. He needs to get Pogba in the team, and we need to get our better players on the pitch, because that shit last night is not good enough for Manchester United to be playing like that at home. It's not good enough. Two CDMs, it's an embarrassment. It's an embarrassment. We need to do better. Yes, Rashford and Martial missed chances, but they didn't get loads of chances, and they should be getting more against West Brom. Getting really fed up with this shambles now. To say we're playing like Burnley would be harsh on them. I think the end is near for Ollie. Dreadful, says Craig Thomas Miller. Ricky criticised Bruno, even though he was our best player. Yeah, he doesn't talk about how bad Mata and Matic were. I don't understand this at all, says Salah Ahmed. Mark, Spurs play defensively and still score and get results. Why can't United do the same, says Kendall. And as an attacking player back in the day, wouldn't you think Ollie would have more of an attacking mindset the way he sets up his line each week, says Chris. I think Ollie wants to play as a more offensive side. I really do. But I think that he's scared. I said this yesterday, and unfortunately, he's trying to keep his job now. So as Manchester United purists, we want to see a United side that we're proud of. What we've actually created now is somebody who's desperately trying to keep their job. And if you're trying to desperately keep your job, you try not to concede goals. I mean, look, it's very simple. And, you know, I don't care whether you're Gary Neville or Gary Smith or Ole Gunnar Solskjaer or Ollie Watkins or whatever. The reality is, I'd argue this out with anybody, he's trying not to lose. Yes, he wants to win, but he's trying not to lose more. Yesterday, it was as if he went into that game and went, if I get a draw or we nick a win, I'm all right. But if I lose this game, I'm in trouble. So what does he do? He goes deep defensive line. He gets two CDMs in front of him. He isolates the forward and packs, you know, the defensive line in the midfield area. And, you know, West Brom didn't really create that much, did they? But if that had been a draw, we'd be moaning even more, but he wouldn't be getting the sack. So he's trying not to lose games at the moment. And I think, in a way, I sort of understand that. But Manchester United's fan base is too volatile to sit there and go, well, we won 1-0. The United fan base, and Ollie knows it, it's not just about winning, it's about how we win. And look, the harsh truth is, we've been here with Van Gaal and Mourinho. We've won those type of games with them, and it wasn't good enough. So you can't suddenly rewrite history and start saying, well, you know, West Brom are a good side, they've got a lot of quality, and it's about the 3 points. Because unfortunately, Ollie, if you know your history, we've been here. We've had managers come out and say, We've won the game. I don't know what people are moaning about. All right, I've played two CDMs, but it's about winning the games. Van Gaal did it. Mourinho did it, and people got very pissed off with it. You can win games as a United manager and lose support of the fans. And that's what Ollie's got to be very, very careful about for two reasons. One, if we keep winning like this, people will not be happy. Two, he won't win like this. Play like that yesterday, you will lose more than you win. Because West Brom didn't have any quality in the final third, so they couldn't really hurt us. Pogba haters reporting to duty. Pogba is world class. He wants out. United wants him in. Fans, if you want him out, talk to Ed, not Pogba, says True United. And Genwell Belandaris says, Mark, which competition do you think will get Ollie the sack? The Champions League, if you don't qualify for the knockout and drop to Europa League, or not qualify at all the leagues, says Genwell. I don't really know about the sack, really. I mean, we can talk about that in a moment. But I do want to talk about Bruno there. I haven't actually seen Ricky's fan cam yet. It's on my list to do this morning because I finished late last night and I was just like, I'm going to go and watch The Mandalorian. So, sorry, Ricky, I prefer The Mandalorian to you last night. And, you know, it was a 1-0 win. What I did find funny is that... you know, it doesn't massively surprise me that Ricky spoke negatively about Bruno, because if he did, a lot of people were messaging me on social media about it, saying that, you know, there's people going in on Bruno. I can only describe this at this point as a total lack of football knowledge. And I hate to do that because it's such an arrogant thing to say. But at this point, it's beyond agenda. It's ridiculous. There must be, you know, like sometimes you're walking into school or work or you're on a train and you see somebody, you've never spoke to them in your life and you think, I cannot stand you, even though you've done nothing. There must be something about Bruno Fernandes that people look at him and go, I don't like you, because there is no sense to this at all. I could spend 5 minutes going through every one of United's last 10 games and proving that Bruno Fernandes is our best player. It's not just about creating chances. He should have had 2 assists yesterday. You know, 2 more assists to already our biggest goal and assist midfielder and one of the best in Europe. He's created more chances than any other player in the Premier League this season. And he's played 1 game less than most of them. Yes, he scores a lot of penalties, but creating chances has got nothing to do with penalties. He's a centre-attacking midfielder. His job is to create, and that's what he does. He's the best in the Premier League with De Bruyne at doing it. In fact, he's the best in the Premier League because De Bruyne is playing shite at the moment. Bruno Fernandes is the best attacking midfielder in the Premier League at the moment, but some of our fans don't think he's shit. And tell me that's not based on an agenda. I don't know. I just can't understand it. But on top of that, when you look at the game yesterday... He's made the second most amount of tackles, the second most amount of interceptions. He'll be up there for distance covered. He's the leader of the team. Like he does absolutely everything. And that pass that he played from, to Mata, the way the ball moved, the way he cuts across the ball, and the way it's flight across the air and the accuracy. There's only Paul Pogba who can do that in that team. So. You know, what is it? You know, Donny van der Beek can't do that. He doesn't pass like that. He hasn't got that sort of a pass. It's not just about hitting a ball 40 yards. It's about the way the ball is weighted and the way it moves through the air to take out a whole defence but land perfectly for Mata. There's only Pogba who can hit a ball like that. Very like Paul Scholes. It's a certain way to hit a ball. You've got to be very technically gifted to hit it like that. I could hit that ball to Mata, but it would be flying at him like a bloody missile, because to hit it, you've got to hit it hard. But it's the way, the technique on the ball, it's almost cutting through the ball so that the ball's spinning and slowing down in the air. It's glided but fast. Absolutely amazing technique. And that's just one pass. Of course, he'll give the ball away. He's going to give the ball away. I don't get people who say, well, he gave the ball away 20 times. Yeah, maybe he did. But he created 2 great chances. And he had a very, very good game. He gives the ball away because he's a creative risk taker. If you're trying to cut apart a defence and take 3 players out of the game, you're going to not do it every time. But he's the only player who wants to do it. Absolutely fantastic player. And if you don't get it, you need to look beyond your hate, because every area of his game is sitting you down. Like, it's ridiculous, absolutely ridiculous. And I don't understand it, but it definitely exists out there. And look, I don't really care about agendas because, look, Paul Pogba will leave United. I hope he does. I think it's best for him and it's best for us. Is he committed to the club? I'm not 100% sure, but he should be playing for the club, because McTominay and Fred and Matic as two CDMs ain't good enough. It should be Fred and Pogba and Bruno as a midfield three. Matic ain't got the legs at the moment. McTominay's not good enough. We can't keep playing two CDMs to bench Van der Beek and Pogba. It's ridiculous. It's cowardly. It's defensive. And there's no decent coach in the world that would be benching Pogba and Van der Beek to play two CDMs. They wouldn't do it. They would. I tell you what it is. It's a test of coaching nous. It's not easy. I'm not going to sit here and say it's easy to get Van der Beek, Pogba, Bruno in the same team. Not really easy. You've got to be a good coach to do it, but most good coaches would do it. It's easier to say, I'm going to bench quality players. Can you two Duracell bunnies put your batteries in your back and just protect the two slow centre-backs that I've got? And that's what we're doing at the moment. There's not a lot of... It's not great coaching to put two CDMs in front of two slow centre-backs and try and hit a team on the break. That's not great coaching. Great coaching is to play Fred and Pogba together and, you know, coach them so that they know how to cover the back four but also be more progressive. Get Van der Beek on the right. It's all... Good coaching would have those playing. And that's why your Zidane's and your Pep's and, you know, most managers would do it. These agendas need to stop. Ollie said in his post-match that he only prepped yesterday for team. I agree he could do better, but people need to relax and back their manager. Blame is on higher-ups for not investing in right players. Hashtag back your manager, says JL. Look, at the end of the day, I want to be absolutely... I want to reiterate my stance here. I'm not happy this morning. He's got to be less of a coward in relation to how he sets his team up. I totally disagree that he's not had long enough to get the team ready. He picked the same team as he picked against Everton. The same formation. The team. I don't care if he's had a week to prep or 10 minutes to prep. He still played two holding midfielders and we all knew he was going to do that. That's not an excuse. However, what I would say is I want Ollie to succeed. Do I believe he can? At the moment, I'm not convinced because the way he's playing, he will get the sack. He's going to sack himself. He's trying not to lose. He's playing defensive football. He's going to get the sack. But there's always hope. There's always hope. And Istanbul is a big chance for him to not play two centre defence midfielders and try something a little bit more offensive. Now, I'm absolutely convinced when we play Southampton in a week's time and we play West Ham and we play PSG and we play Leipzig and we play Man City, we're going to see more of what we saw yesterday. I cannot see that he's going to start playing Fred with a more offensive-minded holding midfielder like Pogba. I just can't see he's going to do it. It's going to be Matic and Fred or McTominay and Fred, and we're going to see Van der Beek and Pogba on the bench for most of those games. And that, to me, will end up with him ultimately at some point getting the sack. But if Ole Gunnar Solskjaer is listening or sat there at home or whatever, Ollie, you're going to sack yourself if you keep going with two holding midfielders in front of those defenders. Get Tuansebe in there and play a little bit more offensive like Manchester United should be. Because you might not get sacked before Christmas. You might not even get sacked in the summer. But this mentality, you will sack yourself because it's not Manchester United. And I'm not saying it's terrible. You won the game, it's great. But we've been here before. I think the most important message is this. We as a fan base are waking up this morning saying, well, look, it's good that we won. I hope we can keep winning. There's a real opportunity this season if you keep winning. But we can't be hypocrites. We saw this with Van Gaal and we hated it. We saw it with Mourinho and we hated it. They won games. Mourinho took us to second. Van Gaal won us an FA Cup. But the football was no better than what we're seeing now. We're meant to be turning a new corner. You cannot say we're turning a new corner. The future is ours. And then just repackage the same old crap football that we've seen under Mourinho and Van Gaal. If that was the case, we never should have sacked Mourinho. We never should have sacked Van Gaal. They shouldn't have been sacked because we're playing exactly the same style of football now. We didn't sack Mourinho and Van Gaal just because of results. A lot of it was to do with they lost the fan base because of the style of football. I understand Ollie is afraid to lose, but then how can you trust Maguire and an unfit Lindelof to do the job, says Deepak Singh. I think that's a great point from Deepak. I mean, the trust element is a big issue. It really is. The trust problem is a big issue because yesterday he played Lindelof, who's injured, rather than play Tuansebe. So that shows you he doesn't trust Tuansebe, pure and simple. So he takes off a crap Mata to put a crap Rashford on the right wing instead of taking Mata off of Van der Beek. That shows you he doesn't trust Van der Beek. I hate to say that, but he doesn't. That was ridiculous yesterday. Mata came off with 25 minutes to go, was it? Half an hour, 25 minutes to go. It should have been Mata for Van der Beek. He takes Mata off for Cavani, moves Cavani up front, Martial to the left, and puts Rashford on the right. Now, we've all said Rashford should play on the right. We've been saying it for 3 years. But you don't put him on the right when he's playing shit. You know, he should have come off. And then what? 15 minutes later, he takes Rashford off and puts Van der Beek on the right. And Van der Beek ends up with 10 minutes. He doesn't trust certain players. That's very, very, very clear. But I'm telling you, he's got to start Van der Beek against Istanbul. He has to do it. Because if he doesn't, when's the next opportunity for Van der Beek to get in the team again? I would love to see Bruno deeper with Pogba playing as two number eight, says Mohamed to Hassan. Well, you could do that. You could do that, Mohamed. There's no reason why you couldn't do that. I mean, look, there's an evolution here for what Solskjaer needs to do. But I'll argue it with anybody. The reality is that the team that we played against Sevilla, which was this midfield three, it worked really well. Now, why can't he do that midfield three? You know, Fred's deeper, but he's got the support of Pogba and he's got the support of Bruno. Why can't he do that midfield three? I'll tell you why he can't do that midfield three. Because for some reason, we have an inability to coach. Like, I'm not a Premier League coach or a national team coach, and neither of you. But if you have a decent coach, you're telling me you can't tell Fred to just patrol this area and be disciplined and break up the play and don't go wandering forward so that the centre-backs are exposed. You're telling me, Paul Pogba, who plays a deeper role with France anyway, Paul, I want you to support Fred and help him out when we haven't got the ball, but when we have got the ball, you can be a little bit more attacking. And the same with Bruno. Bruno's back in the penalty box, giving penalties away. He's in that penalty box scoring goals. You're telling me Bruno can't do a back and forth role? There are loads and loads of ways that we could play. We could even go back to the diamond because Mata's ineffective. There's loads of things we can do if we coach our good players effectively. And the reality is, at the moment, we choose not to do that. We choose not to coach our players in an effective way. And we choose a lazy option, which is, I tell you what, Matic and McTominay or Matic and Fred or whoever, Pogba get on the bench, Van der Beek get on the bench. What I want to do is I want to have absolutely no pace on the right-hand side, no progression. Wan-Bissaka, don't you dare go past the halfway line. Mata, I don't know what you're going to do, but basically our right-hand side's dead. I want you two to just stay in front of these two because they're slow. Telles, be great if you could go forward if you can, but really you're probably going to spend most of your time as a left back. And we're going to isolate our front, Rashford and Martial and make teams swamp our left side because we don't have a right side. And that's basically what happened yesterday. It's not difficult coaching and we're not being anywhere near expansive. And one thing that I would say, and I've sort of stayed quiet about this as well. And look, people are going to say you've been very negative, but it's not even negative. It's constructive. It's constructive because I know, like many of you know, because our community is actually, whether you're Ollie in or Ollie out, you're very intelligent. I see it every day. What I was going to say is this, that we are, people saying stop with the Ollie out, but when you're at home against West Brom and he plays two CDMs, come on. Jose used to get slated for it. It says Sean Negative Turner, which is perfect. Absolutely spot on. I haven't glitched. I'm absolutely fine. But what I was going to say is, please smash a like on the video if you are watching. Just refresh. I don't know what happened there, sorry. What I was going to say is that a lot of people have said this to me, and I think they're right. I'd never really thought about it like this, but just stick this in your head for a Sunday morning, you know, ponder. The point is this. If Graham Potter at Brighton or Ralph Hasenhüttl, whatever his name is, at Southampton, was in charge of Manchester United's squad, do you think they would set up the team like it was set up against Everton and West Brom? Do you think they would play with two CDMs and counter-attacking football? Well, of course they wouldn't, because they've got worse players at Southampton and worse players at Brighton, and they don't play with two holding midfielders. And I think that's the greatest criticism and construction I can give towards Ollie and his coaches, is that you've got a massive array of fantastic talent. You are benching a lot of it. Do you think Graham Potter at Brighton would bench Pogba and Van der Beek and Cavani and Greenwood to play McTominay and Matic and Mata? He would be like, this is Christmas. Imagine what a coach could do with... Imagine what Potter or Hasenhüttl at Southampton would do if we gave them all our players. No, I'm not saying come and be United manager. I'm not saying they should be United manager. But what I'm saying is you would see a very different Brighton and a very different Southampton in relation to where they are in the league if you gave those good coaches the quality that we've got. And I think that's a really thing. And it's not just against Ollie. I mean, you could say the same against other coaches at times, but there are some fantastic coaches in the Premier League who will be sacked or relegated because they don't have the quality that we've got. And I mean, Haider Official said, sorry, that got pinned and then it got took off. If it's frozen for you, just refresh the stream. Yeah, exactly. Haider says that they wouldn't. They would press high up the pitch and go on the front foot with their good attacking football. And this is what I mean. Look, Brighton, when we played them, but if you watch Brighton, they're a good footballing side who lack the quality of most of the Premier League in their squad. So this is a point. This is a really good point. And it's not an Ollie out point, although Ollie outers will love it. And it's not something Ollie inners should ignore. It's a valid point. It's a question mark. It's a very relevant question. You know, to be fair, a decent journalist should ask this in an Ole Gunnar Solskjaer press conference. Ollie, you won at the weekend, you've beaten Everton, but the criticism that you're getting is that the football isn't entertaining enough for a Manchester United side. And with the quality that you've got, what do you think a team like Brighton would do? Because they've got a style of football with less quality players. It's a really good point. It's a really good point, and it's not one I can defend. Why are Manchester United, and look, Van Gaal did it and Mourinho did it, but why are Manchester United, with all the quality that we've got, playing a brand of football that you'd probably see on a Sunday morning down on the park? You know, it's defensive, counter-attacking football, and yet we've got players that have won World Cups. We've got players that Real Madrid and Barcelona want. We've got flair players that want to play attacking football, and they're being restricted by this negative, cowardly football. And there's just no way in the world that, you know, Graham Potter or most of the Premier League managers would play that way. They just wouldn't do it. They'd play the way they want to play with better players than they've currently got. And that is where the coaching flaw comes into it. Now, look, I've seen Ollie play good football. I've seen him do it in the summer. I've seen him do it when he first came into the club. We didn't play deep counter-attacking football then. He can do it, but at the moment, he's playing counter-attacking football defensive because he's terrified of losing his job. And effectively, it's a harsh word, but we're playing like a bunch of cowards. We're Manchester United and we're playing like a bunch of cowards. We're protecting our players. Some fans who don't understand football are now saying that Maguire and Lindelof are a good partnership. They're not a good partnership. They're being protected. They're in a bubble. They're protected by two CDMs and two fullbacks that are tucking in. I was thinking about this. Wan-Bissaka played very, really badly yesterday and he deserves criticism. And Rashford played badly. And they're beyond the agenda players. You know, Bruno, Pogba, Martial. They're players that people just have an issue with and they're always on the headlines. Rashford and Wan-Bissaka played terribly yesterday. But you know the chance that West Brom had where De Gea made the great save? I couldn't believe that Aaron Wan-Bissaka was not marking the back post again. Against Brighton, this kept happening again and again and again. There's two issues here. Either Wan-Bissaka is so stupid, he doesn't understand that a right back should be covering his back post, or he's being told not to do it. I think it's the latter. I think he is being told to tuck in and protect Lindelof, and that is why he's leaving the back post. It's a tactical thing. It has to be. And that's what I mean. We're overprotecting weak players like Lindelof and Maguire, and that is making us very, very defensive. Please smash a like on the video if you're watching. Omar says, among the problems of Manchester United, there are players without experience. I would expect Ronaldo, he would solve many problems. We need experience in order to benefit the young players. They'll bring back Danny Welbeck, says Mikel Reach. I mean, look, on Cristiano Ronaldo, Juventus, I think it was their chief executive yesterday, said that you can rest assured that that Ronaldo's future is with Juventus. But look, the future is 8 months away. That could be when he goes. Who knows? But what I would say about Cristiano Ronaldo is that he wouldn't accept that performance yesterday. He wouldn't be happy with it. He wouldn't be happy in the dressing room. He would demand more. And Bruno spoke the same after the pitch. But Ronaldo would have scored the chance Martial scored with a blindfold on. He would have scored the chance Rashford had with a blindfold on. It might not have been clean, it might not have looked as good, but he would have made sure he scored because that's what quality players do. There's no excuse for Martial and Rashford yesterday. Those finishes were not good enough. But we won the game, we move on, and I tell you what, there's not going to be a massive amount of opportunity for us to get away with what we did yesterday. And so, look, ultimately, where would we be without Bruno Fernandes? I mean, where would we be without Bruno Fernandes? You can criticise him if you want, but I'd love people to answer where we would be. We would be nowhere. We would be in the Europa League and we would be in the mid-table, probably in relegation zone this season, to be fair. Bruno Fernandes is head and shoulders our best player, and without him, we would be lost. And also, we won the game. And whether you want Pochettino in or Ole out or whatever, it was very important that we won the game yesterday, because he wasn't going to get the sack off yesterday anyway. In many ways, we are still in the same position we were in when that news came out from the Manchester Evening News. His job isn't safe. There's still a lot of people who doesn't want him to be here. He's not answered the critics. He's won two games, but he's won two games in a very average way. And he's not answered any questions. Ultimately, we still don't know what his best 11 is. We still don't know what the style of play is. We're still playing very defensive football. So yeah, two wins is great. Absolutely fantastic, Ollie. You've got to keep winning. What's the plan? And we're still sat here going, what is the plan? Is this the plan? Is that your best team that you started with yesterday? Is this the plan? Because if it is, the inevitable will happen. He's got to change things. Our next game might be the last game for Ollie to try a different formation and start trusting the diamond against his Depay. I think Istanbul on Tuesday night is huge. Van der Beek has got to start. You can't rest Bruno because we need to win. If Pogba's fit, he's got to start. As I said, for me, Fred, Pogba, Bruno, midfield three, Van der Beek to the right, Rashford, Martial, that's your team. Or even rest Martial and play Cavani, I don't care. There are many caveats to Ollie's circumstances, but ultimately he's not a very good coach. That's his job. If I was a postman and I wasn't very good at delivery, I'd be out of a job, says Paul Robinson. There you go. Please smash a like on the video, everybody. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're new. Bottom right-hand corner. Sunday night show at 8 o'clock tonight. And if you want some watch-alongs, I'm doing them on Mark Goldbridge, That's Football. So subscribe there. Arsenal Leeds at 4 o'clock. So hopefully Leeds will win that. Thanks everyone for watching. Lots of interesting stuff. Very happy that we won. And very, very grateful to Bruno Fernandes. What a player he is. He's getting us out of trouble. He's our best player. We should appreciate him, because without him, we'd be way, way worse. Also, download the Flick app. Link's in the video description. It's free. Man United chat, United Stand chat app, where you can be chatting away for 24/7 amongst yourselves. The poll is there. Will Ole Gunnar Solskjaer be manager by Christmas? That's on the Flick app. It's free on Apple and Android. Give it a download. Smash a like, subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you at 8 o'clock. Going to be a big show, because I tell you what, I reckon Flex is Ollie out. I think it's obvious. Speak to you in a bit.